Yeah, that's not level. But what is level these days anymore?
Hey everyone, I hope you're doing well. You'll have to forgive some of the background noise. It's the wind blowing around out there at about 20 some miles per hour. I was going to say that Mother Nature must be pissed off about something, but nature is not female or male and doesn't have emotions. So it's just the indifferent universe doing its indifferent random kind of thing. Hopefully the roof will stay on during the remainder of this video, doing its thing regardless of what we think or have to say about it. So welcome to my channel if you're new. Welcome back if you're an existing subscriber. And if you are new to my channel, everyone's welcome. Really, I don't care if you're, no matter you're black or white, gay or straight, believe in God, don't believe, but whatever. Well, first off, I don't really have any control of who watches my videos. And I'm not here to, say only certain people are allowed to watch. That's kind of ridiculous. But I do welcome anyone. I'm not going to say like this is a safe space. No, I'll get into that. But there might be some things that you might not agree with or get offended by. Though it's not my intent to offend, really. But that's kind of a topic for another video. So, as you can already tell and surmise by the title of this video and by my talking, I'm taking a break once again from the typical ASMR format of my channel. That's just what I do from time to time. And which is why my channel name is Ephemeral Rift, not Ephemeral ASMR or Ephemeral Rift ASMR or something with ASMR in it or whispering. Because when I created my channel back in 2011, while I experienced ASMR all my life, I had no idea ASMR was a thing until the following spring of 2012. So I just left the channel as it is. And I continue to just be my self and create and go with the flow and see where my brain takes me. I do try to create mostly the ASMR entertaining content because I know you and many folks out there just want to escape, want something to relax, okay? But right now, I'm taking a break because I'm just following my brain. And apparently it wants me to do a few of these videos before I get back to doing ASMR. So I'm also coming to you before we get into the main topic of this video. I'm coming to you as a non-expert, as someone on your level. Not as some kind of arrogant, pompous know-it-all who wants to claim they're an expert. I'm just a human being. I never asked to be born. Now, I wasn't sitting in some magical, ethereal plane saying, let me see. I want to take the body of, yeah, I want to be born to that Caucasian couple in that, what's that called? Pennsylvania? Yeah, Pennsylvania. Let me see what else. Yeah, so I didn't choose to be here. This is just, I'm here and I am a sensitive person. Sensitive meaning that you could call it highly sensitive, and you might be too. Thought I'm any a little different maybe than some people, but some of us sensitives, it's not a sign of weakness. It just means that some people, like myself, like you, like a lot of others, have a very sensitive nervous system, and we just take everything in, often beyond, well, of course, it's, you know, a lot of it's automatic. Our brains just see, and then we can just, we're very emotional. We do a lot of thinking, a lot of analyzing. It's tiring. I am tired as I creep slowly towards 50 years old. I'm tired of thinking and analyzing, which is why I don't do a lot of these videos. I do my ASMR YouTube video. I spend almost a full day editing, and then I gotta get away from the computer, and I go to my downtime is watching some kind of a film or a movie, or usually some sort of intellectually stimulating show, although I'm not some kind of elitist, because I do like to watch The Simpsons. I do like to watch Young Sheldon. Not too much TV. I do like to watch Mountain Men on occasion. But I'm not a big reader. And you know, I'm a simple guy. Like I said, I'm just trying to make sense of the world. Trying to understand things. I have no dogma. I have no ideology. I don't want to be a cult leader. I don't want followers. I just want to do this because it's quite cathartic, and share it with anyone out there in case it might help someone, you know, that's going through the same thing, because we are very similar in a lot of ways, in many ways. Even though our interests might be different, we all have hunger, we all have carnal desires, we all make mistakes, you know, we all have something about us that we're insecure about, you know, everyone does. So that's all. I'm basically just taking, you know, my thoughts and sharing them. No different than what, again, Marcus Aurelius, Roman emperor, did. This is his writings. It's basically a recording of his private notes to himself and ideas on Stoic philosophy. He wrote the 12 books of the Meditations as a source of his own guidance in self-improvement. And that's all I've been trying to do throughout my life, is stop a lot of the bad behaviors that I used to do, avoid narcissistic, hypocritical tendencies and behaviors, which is can be very impossible as a human being, which is a video I want to get into about how it's nigh impossible to not be a hypocrite, so that I can live a virtuous life, not a, as close to as my own idea of an ideal life. So that's, you know, I'm an observer, and I'm trying to make sense of the world. And that's why we're here with this video. People ruin a good thing. Or I should say, people always ruin a good thing, which is how I think I'm going to title the video, and how destruction is in our nature. Why do I think this way? Because I believe and have the perspective that we were born out of the primordial soup, however many billions of years ago, millions, when life first began to form on Earth. You know, once the sun began to warm up the Earth and life began to propagate. So, destruction, we come from the Earth. The Earth gave birth to us in a metaphorical, somewhat in a literal sense, really. I mean, the first single cell organisms eventually evolved into different things, and there is thought that we evolved from worms, that our first brain was our stomach, that the brain in our skull is our second brain. That's some very interesting stuff to get into. It's somewhat of a scientific type of stuff. There's a good documentary out there about the two brains, which probably explains our duality and our conflict, internal conflict and such. But I'm going to try to stay on track and talk about the title of this video. So let's get to it. We always seem to ruin a good thing, and I believe it's because destruction is in our nature. Because we come from nature, and nature is about creation and destruction. So, let's start with our hands. All right? We evolve with hands, and they are great tools. We use them in about three or four ways, primarily, to create, out of to help, to aid others. You know, let me help you up. Let me apply a bandage on you. You know, to say hello, shake your hand, hug you. You know, compassion. All right. So, and the destructive nature is why we always ruin a good thing. We have these great tools right here. And what do we often do? What do people often do? Turn them into fists to use in unnecessary acts of violence. Now, there are warranted acts of violence when you need to defend yourself. Someone is being verbally or physically abusive to you. Someone is about to do something to you. And so what do? You know, you go into that defensive attack mode. And I think that's warranted, standing up for yourself. Okay? Sometimes it just comes down to that, and you gotta throw a punch. I've been in those situations as a kid. I've been in three fights. I've been in about, a fourth was a kind of a tussle, with people who I once thought were friends and some other kids that I were just classmates. I remember getting a fight with one kid. I don't remember how, but we were walking on the way home, and I'm not sure if someone was egging us on. I don't know how it transpired. But there was this classmate, and we just squared off. This was back in the 70s or 80s. We did not know how to fight. So there's these two skinny 12-year-old white boys on the street in the suburbs, heading home after school. And we're like this for 5 minutes. You know, we don't know how to fight. And there's a couple kids, you know, around watching us. You know, eventually throw a punch. I don't know how to fight. Throw a punch. I don't even know if I hit the guy. And I actually got cramps after about 5 minutes of this nonsense. And I just, that was it. We kind of walked away. And I don't know if we ever spoke to each other since. Stupid stuff. Not proud of it, you know? Just, I wish I could go back and talk, you know? I wish I could go back in time and talk to myself and talk to these other kids about the stupid behaviors, unnecessary behaviors that we get involved in. Anyway, so there was that. There was another fight I got involved with another kid from school. We met up on another schoolyard. It was like 9 o'clock at night. I think he punched me. I'm not sure if I ever landed a punch on him. It was just, again, it was just, okay, you know, let's go meet up and fight. I don't even know why. Stupid reasons. I said three fights. Now I can't remember what the third one is. And the fourth tussle I got involved in, there was a good friend of mine. We were in fourth or fifth grade. We used to hang out. And all of a sudden, we just started to become our worst enemies. And after school one day, I don't know what happened, but he ended up getting on top of me, sitting on my chest. And it was just, you know, wasn't throwing any punches, but was this kind of, it was like, do you give? And I was like, yeah, I give. Stupid man. Anyway, this is funny. So, but that's the one tool, the one thing you give us. Nature gave us hands, evolution, to create, to make tools. And what do we do? Senseless acts of violence. And then when we do make tools, like this Swiss Army knife. Here's a tool, a knife, very useful. We ruin this as well and use this in senseless acts of violence. Or we use this tool to make another tool. Here is, I've kind of whittled this a little bit. I would love to do a whittling video, carving, but I'm not a whittler, you know? But, I don't know. There's plenty of experts out there, but if you want to see me whittle a sharp stick, I guess I can do that in an ASMR video. But here we go, right? Turn this stick, use this tool for a good purpose, to hunt. And what is hunting? Hunting is killing another organism. That's the destruction I'm talking about. Now, this isn't anything new. I'm sure this has been discussed in other articles and other thoughts, okay? So I'm not coming here as some kind of expert. I'm just trying to understand, observe, and analyze to understand things from my own personal understanding and knowledge and growth and improvement and share that with you. I'm not trying to be someone like a flat earther, and that's going to be the next video after this one. I'm going to talk about that and most especially the harm of that and many other things like aliens, Bigfoot, Illuminati, even God. But I'm not here to say, you know, hey, we are destructive, we come from nature, follow me, buy my shirt, you know, join my cult. No, this is just me sharing a personal observation. So anyway, that's that. One tool that is often a knife, often used in senseless acts of violence. So again, we ruin a good thing. Let's pretend this is a spear. Spear used to hunt. No, we have to kill. It's in our nature. That's the duality. That's that aggression that builds up. And the more and more we, which is, this is probably another topic for another video, the more and more we get away from our humanity, hunting that we used to do, and now it's in the hands of a few companies. Really, do you hunt? No, we go to the supermarket and we get our food. Where does our food come from? Who's making it? Anyway, destruction is in our nature. It's even in our physical makeup with the cells. How many cells are created and destroyed in our body? So let's just imagine this is a spear, used a tool used to hunt. But we all know, as with the knife, it ends up becoming a weapon used in many senseless acts of violence. Again, we've ruined a good thing. Can't just use it as a tool to hunt and for survival. It's got to be for war. Now, we could talk about competition and competing and that whole aspect of survival. And I, you know, got to give some credence and, you know, lend some weight to that argument. But that's another video, okay? I don't want to get into so many different little small things and avenues we could discuss about everything I'm talking about here. But I can't do a 5-hour long video. What else? Well, another good thing that we've created is medicine. Another advancement of science and technology, plastic bottle, although, you know, plastic itself, not the the greatest thing that we've created, especially with, you know, a lot of the pollution and stuff involved, etc. But medicine, you know, how often I use aspirin, I got a headache, you know, or Motrin, dealing with something, and you go, you know, you go to that sinus thing, you got sinus congestion, use the nose spray, whatever. But again, how often have we ruined this, right? And you know what I mean, like the Robitussin. And now, because of certain people, us, we've learned how to turn this, certain medicines, into harmful drugs and opiates. So again, we've ruined a good thing. It's in our nature. We are the great ruiners. Now, here we have some glasses. And I don't know if we actually ruined this other than putting a hefty price tag on glasses. A drinking glass, very good, useful tool. Has someone thrown a drinking glass at someone as a weapon? Yeah, so you could say that we've ruined a good thing, but saying, comparing a glass as a weapon to a knife or a spear, not quite the same thing. Fruit. We've learned how to create agriculture, which might have been a bad thing. We could get into a discussion about agriculture and how it might have, been the decline of civilization. You know, ruined the whole hunter-gatherer thing, etc. But we have made lots of food available in an abundant amount. And we probably have ruined that by putting, maybe price tags on it. Again, we could talk about capitalism, things like that. So there's some pros and cons here, but there's the indifferent universe whipping around out there. And before I forget, another tool we've created is language, a way for us to express ourselves. A lot of words we've created. A lot of words that probably were created and started out with innocent intent to describe something. But then what do we do? Like, there's a word in here, starts with N, and I'm not going to say that word, but I am going to show you in here. Well, here's narcissism. excessive interest in or admiration of oneself and one's physical appearance. That narcissism word, narcissism, just to get off on a tangent. Now, we're all a little bit narcissists, but it's getting rampant and out of control with just, I don't want to get into a whole thing about that, but I just wanted to bring that up real quick. Narcissistic behavior, very difficult to overcome and change, but people can change. Another topic for another video. Now, here's a word in here, starts with N. The Spanish origin was Negro, meaning black. So the word has been perverted by us. And right in here, it has usage. This word is very offensive and should not be used. So I'm glad they put that in there for someone that might not know what that word means. It's very responsible to do that. And maybe that word, if it is that offensive and should not be used, shouldn't even be in the dictionary. But that is, like I said, I don't want to get into whole words and swear words and all that kind of thing. So there we have it. We've created language and we've ruined it by using some of those words, turning them into slurs, using them as insults, using words to verbally abuse people. Medicine, we've taken that, use it to create a drug, methamphetamine, etc. Tools, great tools for many useful purposes, turn them into weapons of senseless violence. And I don't think it has anything to do with evil or Satan. I was raised Roman Catholic, and I was taught that. And at some point, I was 10 or 11, I began to think to myself, you know what, I don't really agree with any of this. I don't believe in any of this. So I checked out mentally. I still had to go to Catholic school until I was 18. It was a big point of turmoil in my life, and has been, or it was, for 40 years of my life. Only until the last few years have I really, like I said before in other videos, finally escaped the claws and grasp of Catholicism and its teachings. So destruction is in our nature. And I don't necessarily, not just destruction, but we are emotional as well. And we have those primal traits still within us, emotions. No one really understands what they are. Why do we have them? Fear. Fear is useful and beneficial. And there's love as well. But then things get out of control and we take a tool, like a knife, and out of impulse, in an emotional moment, out of fear, we use it to destroy that which opposes us, that which we think is trying to harm us, or that which we just hate. And that is dangerous, that hate. And it's never going to change. Because every single human being born on this planet, until you wipe out whatever emotions, until you genetically modify people so that they can no longer express or feel hate, strong, intense anger, nothing is going to change. There will never be a utopia. And we are constantly going to have this battle of prejudice and hate. And instead of just, you know, I've been guilty of using words in a harmful manner. I'm not proud of it. I just didn't know. But I've never spent a night in jail, never performed an act of violence on anyone. I have engaged in physical altercations, but I've never stabbed anyone, is what I mean. And while I've had a lot of anger and even hate towards people, and I was a very sensitive kid growing up, I was picked on, I was brought to tears, I was spit on. I'm not, you know, trying to make it, you know, but just sharing this, because just as being a white kid, a skinny white kid, somewhat awkward, easy target, heterosexual, but people just found me an easy target. And so I became the victim of name calling. There was one particular name that just mentally stuck with me until my 20s. And whenever I would think of that name, being called that name, it just brought up so much anger. And eventually I just learned to not let my anger get the best of me. It wasn't always easy. Had a lot of baggage. And now I've been reborn in a metaphorical sense. I've just finally reached a really good place. And maybe that's another reason why I'm sharing this, is that if you're going through anything, name calling, feel like a freak, an outsider, an outcast, don't belong, ignored, all those emotions, don't let them cloud your judgment. Don't let them make you do things. Don't try not to act on impulse. It's not easy. It's going to happen. But I like to say there's a light at the end of the tunnel, and you can, hopefully, you know, everybody's different. Everybody's going through so many different things, dealing with so many different things. Not just issues of white or black, gay or straight, but, you know, maybe some kind of handicaps as well. All kinds of things people are going through. So I can't just say everything's going to be fine. No one can promise that. Anything can happen in the next hour. Trees outside here could come eventually, and will. I've seen it on a couple neighbors. Fall into their shed, fall into their house, and now you got this. Hopefully it doesn't fall into you. It's happened. It has happened throughout the world. Tsunamis, just you just don't know. But hopefully you'll make it through life and get to live a somewhat long life, however long that is, and you'll reach some moments of peace of mind. I'm getting off on a tangent here. But we just can't stop ruining a good thing, can we? And it's because I think destruction is in our nature, combined with those emotions. But mostly just the destruction is what I wanted to talk about. Because in order to survive, we must kill. Kill an organism. Now, I know an apple is not the same as an evolved sentient creature like a human being or a dolphin. But no, it's a plant. It's an organism. It has life. It is life. It will provide life. It's not the same as, of course, ending the life of a cow or a chicken, but we have to kill and bring the end of life of any kind of organism, plant, animal, for us to survive. It's just, that is the underlying, the core nature of the universe, of existence, destruction. Why is that the model for life? I don't know. Why can't we be creatures that just absorb the sun's rays, you know, like a plant? But even plants compete and fight. If you've seen any documentaries about the, you know, the Amazon jungles and the trees and the vines and how certain trees will kill one another, and not that they have a consciousness, maybe they do. I'm not wanna go out and be the one to say plants are sentient creatures, but they do compete. It's science is pretty amazing. But that's the model of life. Competition, destruction, battle for resources. It's part of who we are. It's innate to who we are. And I just came here to say that, to talk about that. How we always ruin a good thing. And it's not necessarily a bad thing. Morals. You know? But when you think about it from a moral perspective, how we ruin things, no, it's a bad thing. But who's to say anything about morals or what we can or cannot do? All right, so I take this tool. It's a knife, and I kill someone randomly. That's, society says that's wrong. Society, people have created this thing that's wrong. But outside of the human society, in the rest of the animal kingdom that we are a part of, because we are animals, there are animals killing their young. Some of their young, whether it's a rat or maybe even a lion, for the survival of the pack, survival of the fittest. You know, apes, gorillas, everything. It's just destruction every day. Creation, birth, and destruction, death. Every day, all day long. If you think about it, how many billions of organisms are created and then destroyed in a day? Millions, maybe billions, but think about insects, and you think about flies, mosquitoes, and you think about butterflies, and then you got birds, and then you have fish. It's just a constant creation, destroy, create, destroy, eat, destroy, survival. That's what it is, survival. But when it comes to us, you know, we try to live virtuous, good lives and use these tools for a good purpose. But time and time again, whether it's a knife, whether it's words, whatever it might be, we take them and we'll throw a glass at someone to hurt them, take the medicine, turn it into a drug to sell to someone, knowing that's going to hurt them, and we don't care, it's profiting. You know, or we'll take words and we'll throw them at people and hurt them with mental daggers. So, that's it. I think that's all I have to say on that. And I don't think there's really an answer to it. I'm not looking for an answer. I'd love to hear what you have to say about this topic, of course. Something to think about. And having this, for me, having this mindset about our nature explains a lot. And it doesn't bring any comfort. It's not like, oh yeah, people are destructive. Oh, that's pretty good. Oh, that's nice. Makes me feel good. But it helps me understand why we behave like we do. Because we come from nature, and nature is all about creation and destruction. That's it. That is the model of life in this universe. I wish it were a different way. I wish all the animals, every single organism, could find a way to feed and eat and survive without having to feed off of another organism, like a parasite, or destroy another organism. But that's the model of the universe. So, food for thought, I guess. I forgot about one other aspect to why people ruin everything. And that is greed. Now, that's a whole separate other topic as well. Greed and selfishness, that's that in every individual organism's need for sustaining itself. But when it comes to a good thing, like medicine or food how do we ruin it? Not necessarily in a, you know, by using an apple and throwing it at someone, you know, senseless acts of violence or taking some certain over-the-counter medicines and drugs and using them to create an opiate or a narcotic. But by putting a price tag, instead of giving it away for free, we have capitalism. And I want to get into a big thing here about capitalism, communism, socialism. That's not the point. The point is, we always seem to ruin a good thing. Take YouTube, take this medium, take television, the great tool of television. This was once used a lot more for education, and now has become just a means for profit and entertainment. Imagine how much education and unbiased information could be used on television and cable. You know, but it's not. And that's all I'm trying to get at in regards to the greed aspect. That's the other reason why we ruin everything. Not just from our destructive nature. It's not just using a tool as a weapon, using words as weapons, but also putting value on these things. And maybe there's even something else beyond that. You know, beyond the violence and the destruction and the value is our emotions, our, you know, and desires. Now we can ruin relationships. We can ruin, there's so many things you can think about that we often ruin beyond the scope of the violence and the destruction. But what I'm trying to drive home with this video is more about the destruction and the unnecessary violence. And we could get into the greed, and we could get into how we ruin so many things, YouTube or television or whatnot, you know? So there's that. Take care out there in the indifferent universe. I wish you all the best as you travel on your own journey, trying to make sense of it all in your own way. I hope to see another video real soon. So long. And I'm just going to carve the stick as we fade out here. Maybe I'll do this in a video. You know, when you whittle, you're kind of supposed to use your hands, and you're actually supposed to. I've looked into the whittling videos. I know this isn't actually the right way to do it, but I'm just doing it because I'm not a whittler, and it's not that serious for me. Destruction. I mean, that's destruction right here. Destroy to create a tool. Destroy the trees to create shelter.